Hello viewers, how are you? Welcome to my channel Physics with Rams. So today we are going to discuss about barometer, manometer as well as YouTube. So before going to start this topic, those who are new to my channel, please subscribe my channel so that you can receive notifications regarding the channel as well as you can clear your concepts based on my previous videos. And there are almost 77 videos in my channel. So let's start this topic. Here we are going to discuss about a barometer. Barometer is used to represent the pressure of a fluid at any point. So as we consider our earth, the pressure will be acting up to a height of 200 kilometers from the surface of the earth. Based on this pressure itself, we are stable on the surface of the earth. The pressure is acting perpendicularly on the medium, on any object, either person or any other building, or we can consider any object. So here it is acting perpendicularly to on the surface of the earth like this, in all the directions like this. So here we are representing that barometer is nothing but it is used to measure the pressure at a given point. So here the barometer consists of a vessel which is filled with mercury. Now we are going to consider a thin tube. And now it is being filled with the mercury. It is filled with the mercury. I'm going to close the lid with the thumb like this. I'm going to take it and put the tube in inverted position like this in the mercury. As I put the tube, I will slowly remove the finger. So here what happens is, the mercury will remain in the tube up to a particular height, leaving some space. After that, up to this extent, we have vacuum. This space is represented as a vacuum. From the surface of the liquid, the mercury has risen to a height h. Based on this, now we are going to consider three points. One is a point A and the one is a point B, and we consider point C. Now we have to represent the pressure at this point as well as at this point and pressure at this point. Pressure at point A is represented as a P suffix A. Pressure at point B is represented as a P suffix B, and pressure at C is represented as a P suffix C. Here, as you observe that point A and B are at the same height. Based on that, we can represent a pressure at A is equal to pressure at B. And this pressure at A is equal to atmospheric pressure. Why? Because this atmospheric pressure is acting perpendicularly to the surface of the medium fluid. So here we consider this pressure at A is nothing but atmospheric pressure. Based on that, we can represent a pressure at B is also equal to atmospheric pressure. Based on this height, now we have to represent the pressure at B by considering pressure at C. And we know the common equation as P is equal to P naught plus rho gh. By considering this expression, we are going to represent the difference between the pressures at point B as well as point C. Pressure at B is represented as P suffix B is equal to, where P naught, actually here we have atmospheric pressure, but at point C we don't have atmospheric pressure. Why? Because it is a vacuum. So pressure at point C is considered as a zero. So zero plus rho g h, where h is the height of the mercury raised. So pressure at B is represented as rho gh. But we know that pressure at B is equals to atmospheric pressure. Based on that, atmospheric pressure is represented as rho gh, where rho is a density of this fluid considered, g acceleration due to gravity at that point, h is the height of the mercury level raised. Now, based on this equation, here we are going to represent atmospheric pressure. Whereas atmospheric pressure P naught is equal to rho gh, where rho is nothing but density of the mercury, and density of the mercury is given as 13,600 kg per meter cube. As we substitute this value, the atmospheric pressure is given as 13,600 into gravity, acceleration due to gravity is 9.8 into height. Let us consider the height as 76 centimeters of mercury, because the liquid at sea level, the liquid level will rise up to a height of 76 centimeters for mercury at sea level. Based on that, here I am going to consider the height as h is equal to 76 centimeters of mercury. So as a substitute, we can represent it as 76 by 100. Observe that here two zeros gets cancelled. As we do multiplication, we can represent it as 1.013 into 10 to the power of 5 Pascal. This represents the atmospheric pressure. We can also consider it as 1 atmosphere. We can also consider it as 1 atmosphere. In terms of bar, we can represent it as 10 to the power of 5 bar. And in terms of torr, we can represent it as 1.013 torr. Because this barometer is being explained by torsion, that's why the unit is given for as torr in medicine as well as biological fields. Bar and torr are used in these fields. So based on this, now we are going to discuss some more topic here. Why we have to use mercury? Why can't we use other fluid means? Mercury level rises slightly as compared to other fluids for a high pressure, because its density is more as compared to density of other fluids. We just consider mercury as a solid which is in liquid form. That's why for more pressure, the liquid level will rise for very smaller values. If we consider the height as 70 centimeters, we have to represent the pressure at this level, 70 centimeter. Then atmospheric pressure at this point is given as 13,600 into 9.8 into 70 by 100. So after that, two zeros gets cancelled. As we multiply this, after that 9.8 into 7 7 is 56 5 9 7 is 63 63 is nothing but 68.6, and 6 8 is 6 into 136 6 6 are 36 6 8 is 48 48 plus 3 51 6 6 are 36 41 next 3 6 are 18 8 3 is 24 25 3 6 are 18 20 6 8 6 after that 6 9 5 12 13 8 9. So we have to place dot. Then the expression P naught is equal to 9329.6 Pascal, or we can also represent it as 0.9329 into 10 to the power of 4 Pascal, or we can also represent it as 0.09329 into 10 to the power of 5 Pascals. In this way, we can represent the pressure at different heights. Suppose if we consider water instead of this mercury, the atmospheric pressure. Already we know the atmospheric pressure as 1.01 into 10 to the power of 5 Pascal is equal to density of the water is 1000 kg per meter cube, 10 to the power of 3, into gravity is 9.8 into height is h. So As you observe this expression, 10 to the power of 3 gets cancelled and still we have 2. Then observe that 101 is equals to 9.8 into h. Then h is equals to 101 by 9.8. So as we cancel this, approximately here we get a 10 point some 1 like this meters. Observe that for a difference of smaller values of pressure, the liquid level has to rise a distance of height of 10 meters, which is impossible to up to that length. So instead of maintaining this liquids which are having a less density, we consider a liquid which is having high density, so that the liquid level will rise in very smaller values. So take a screenshot, we will continue. Let's solve a numerical based on this barometer. Observe that what is the reading in barometer when the tube is inclined by an angle of 45 degrees and the vacuum column is at a height of 40 centimeter from the surface of mercury. Observe that the vacuum column is at a height of 40 centimeter perpendicularly from the surface of the fluid, and here this tube has been inclined by an angle of 45 degrees. Remember one point, the pressure always acts perpendicular to the surface of the medium, either it might be fluid or any other solid medium. So here we are going to consider the height as h is equals to 40 centimeters. Already we had discussed this. So we have to represent the pressure, where pressure is represented as p equals to rho g h. P equals rho gh, where rho is density of this mercury, and we know that the density of the mercury is 13,600 kg per meter cube, and the value of g is being considered as 10 meter per second square, and here height is 40 centimeters. So as we substitute these values in this expression, the pressure can be represented as 13,600 into 10 into height is 40 centimeters. Into, we have to convert it into meters, 40 into 10 to the power of minus 2 meter. So 10 to the power of minus 2 and 10 to the power of plus 2 gets cancelled, and 136 into 40 into 10, nothing but 400. So 4, 6, 24, 2, 4, 3 is 12, 12 plus 2, 14, again 1, 4 plus 1, 5, still we have 2 zeros. So 54,400 newton per meter square or Pascal. This represents the pressure. Remember one thing, whether the tube is inclined at any angle, we consider just the height as the vertical or normal from the fluid itself. Take a screenshot, we'll continue. Now we are going to discuss about a manometer. Manometer is a device which is used to find the pressure of a given gas. So initially we consider a gas in a closed container like this, and this container is being attached to a U-tube. It is being attached to a U-tube. This U-tube is being filled with the mercury. Here, pressure of this gas is being compared with the atmospheric pressure. Atmospheric pressure acts at the open end, P naught. Now, here, as you observe that, we consider this point as A, the balancing point to the other end is represented as B, and here we consider this point as C. Observe that from B to C the height is represented as H, As the gas is being filled, so what happens is the gas applies pressure on the mercury. Due to this, the mercury level will decrease in this as well as it rises in this. Suppose if the pressure of the gas is less, then here what happens is the mercury column will increase in this tube and it decreases in the open end of the tube. So based on that we can represent the pressure of this gas. Suppose if the pressure of the gas is maximum, then the mercury column will rise towards the open end up to a height of h, and we can represent that pressure at this point E is equals to pressure at a point B. Based on that we can represent pressure at A is equals to pressure at B, whereas pressure at C is nothing but it is equals to atmospheric pressure. So pressure at C is equals to atmospheric. Why? Because it is open end. After that, the mercury column has rise to a height of h, then the pressure is represented as P suffix B is equals to nothing but P suffix A equals to pressure at point C, nothing but atmospheric pressure plus the liquid column rise to a height h, rho g h. So this pressure at B is nothing but a pressure at A. Pressure at A is equals to P naught plus rho g h. Bring this P naught towards this side, where P naught is atmospheric pressure. P suffix A minus P suffix naught is equals to rho g h. This equation represents the for manometer. Whereas as you observe the P suffix A minus P suffix naught, it represents a gas pressure, G-U-A-G, gas pressure, because it is the difference of pressures based on hydrostatic pressure and atmospheric pressure. That's why it is considered as a gas pressure. Now here, suppose if the pressure of the gas is more as compared to pressure of this atmospheric pressure, then we consider the difference as a positive. If the pressure of the gas is less as compared to atmospheric pressure, then we represent it with a negative sign. Negative sign. Take a screenshot, we will continue. Let's solve a numerical based on this manometer. After that, find the pressure of the gas in manometer when the mercury rises to a height of 9 centimeters. 9 centimeters from the bottom of the tube at open end. At open end. And 3 centimeters at the other end of tube. Now here we have to represent the pressure of the gas which is present in this container. In order to represent this, we know the equation as P minus P naught is equals to rho g h. We have to represent the height by considering the difference between these two heights, where h is equals to h2 minus h1, nothing but 9 minus 3. 9 minus 3 is 6 centimeters. So 6 centimeters can be represented as 6 into 10 to the power of minus 2 meter. And we consider the value of g as 10 meter per second square. And we know the density of the mercury as rho is equal to 13,600 kg per meter cube. And atmospheric pressure as 1.01 into 10 to the power of 5 pascal. So, as we substitute all these values in this expression, we get the pressure of the gas, where P is equals to, the value of P naught is 1.01 into 10 to the power of 5 plus density of the mercury is 13,600 into the value of G is 10 and height is 6 into 10 to the power of minus 2 meters. So, these two zeros gets cancelled for 10 to the power of minus 2. and the pressure is represented as 1.01 into 10 to the power of 5 plus 136 into 10 into 6. So 6 are 36. So here we have 3. 6 3 is 18, 21. 6 1 is 6 plus 2, 8 into 10, nothing but 8600. Since we have a power of 10 to the power of 5, this expression is also represented in terms of 10 to the power of 5. Then observe that is 1.01 into 10 to the power of 5 plus already we have 10 to the power of 4. So we are going to add one more 0, 0.0816 into 10 to the power of 5. So take 10 to the power of 5 as common and add this expression. Then 1.01 plus 8, 9. 16 into 10 to the power of 5 Pascal. This represents the pressure of this gas. Take a screenshot, we'll continue. Now we are going to discuss about U-tube. U-tube is used to compare the two fluids in the same tube. I had considered two fluids. So one is along the one side of the tube and the fluid is along the other side of the tube. In between these two fluids, we have a sliding boundary. Sliding boundary. So here, based on the difference in this density, so this sliding boundary will move towards this side or towards this side. So here the first fluid density is represented as rho 1 and the second fluid's density is represented as rho 2. Suppose if the density of the first fluid is less than density of the second fluid, then this sliding boundary will move towards left. Whereas this sliding boundary will not allow the two fluids to combine, it just passes from one side of the tube to other side like this without combining of these two fluids. Suppose if the density of the first fluid is greater than density of the second fluid, then this sliding boundary moves towards the right like this. In this way, this sliding boundary will change its position. Based on the change in its position, we can find the difference in the heights of the columns based on this density of the fluids. Let's solve a numerical. Observe that if two fluids of density is 0.5 gram per centimeter cube and 1 gram per centimeter cube are filled in a U-tube and the two fluids are initially at a height of 8 centimeter from the bottom. 8 centimeter from the bottom. When the boundary is left freely, the two fluids differ by a height of y centimeters. We have to represent the value of y. So here, observe this diagram. The density of the first fluid is 0.5 gram per centimeter cube and the density of the second fluid is 1 gram per centimeter cube. Based on that, we can represent the density of the second fluid is greater than density of the first fluid. This liquid rises to a height of x, to a height of x, and since the boundary has been changed, the liquid level falls or the fluid level falls to a height of x. Now we have to represent the height. So the total height is given based on this, like this h. Initially it is at a height of 8 centimeters. 8 centimeters. Based on that, height is given as 8 plus x. In the same way, at this position, the height is represented as 8 minus x. Now, we have to compare the pressure towards the right side as well as compare the pressure towards the left side. Whereas the expression is given as P is equal to P naught plus rho gh. Since atmospheric pressure is same on both sides, we neglect this atmospheric pressure. Pressure towards the right side, left side is represented as P1 is equal to density of this fluid is 0.5 into gravity is considered as
1000
is 8 minus x, and pressure towards this end is represented as P2 is equal to density is 1 gram per centimeter cube into height is 8 plus x. Since that both the tubes are open, we can compare both the pressures. As we compare both the pressures, the expression can be represented as 0.5 into 10 to the power of 3 into 8 minus x is equal to 1 into 10 to the power of 3 into 8 plus x. Sure, after that 10 to the power of 3 gets cancelled, and we know the value of 0.2, it can be represented as 1 by 2. So 1 by 2 into 8 minus x is equal to 8 plus x. So bring these two towards this side, then the expression can be represented as 8 minus x is equal to 8 into 2, 16 plus 2x. So here I'm going to bring this x towards this side and send this 16 towards this side. Then here 3x is equal to 16 minus 8, 8. Then here x is equal to 8 by 3, nothing but 3 to the 6. Again we will have 2, 6, 3 is 18, 2.66 centimeters. Here this minus sign will be neglected. Why? Because it shows the difference in the heights. That's why here we are going to neglect the minus sign. Take a screenshot, we will continue. Also the next problem, which is asked in JEE 2014. After that, if fluids of densities D1 and D2 are subtended by an angle of 90 degrees at the center of a circular tube of radius R. So here we consider a circular tube of a radius R, and the sliding boundary makes an angle of alpha with the normal. This sliding boundary, which is placed in between these two fluids, is makes an angle of alpha with the normal from the center of the tube. Now we have to represent the ratio of D1 by D2, where D1 and D2 are the density of two fluids. So here initially we have to represent the height of the fluid. Since the first fluid makes an angle of 90 degrees at the center, the remaining angle is represented as 90 minus alpha, adjacent side by hypotenuse, nothing but cos theta, cos alpha, or cos alpha 90 minus alpha equals adjacent side by hypotenuse, nothing but I am going to represent it as adjacent side by hypotenuse is R. Then adjacent side is equals R cos 90 minus alpha. Cos of 90 minus alpha is sin alpha, R sin alpha. So this represents the adjacent side value, this height. Now we have to represent the height to which the liquid level has been raised. So the liquid level raised is represented as h1 is equal to the radius is r minus r sin alpha. As we take r as common, it can be represented as 1 minus sin alpha. This is the height of the first liquid raised towards this side. H1 is equal to r into 1 minus sin alpha. Now here we have to represent the height of the fluid which has been raised towards this side. Same fluid. So here, this fluid makes an angle of alpha. Adjacent side by hypotenuse, nothing but cos alpha. And this height is represented as r cos alpha. R cos alpha. So now here we have to represent the height, where height can be given as h2 is equals to r minus r cos alpha. So as we take r as common, we get 1 minus cos alpha. So this is the height of the first fluid which has been raised towards the other end. From this end, now here we have to represent the height of the fluid, second fluid which has been raised. So in order to represent this, after that, since it makes an angle of 90 degrees, the angle at this point is considered as 90 minus alpha. So here we will get alpha. Opposite side by hypotenuse, nothing but r sine alpha. R sine alpha. And similarly, this height can also be represented as opposite side by hypotenuse. Whereas this r sine of 90 minus alpha, opposite side by hypotenuse, whereas the angle is 90 minus alpha, then the expression can be represented as r cos alpha. So here we have to represent the height as h3. H3 is equal to r cos alpha plus r sin alpha. As we take r as common, here we get sin alpha plus cos alpha. Now we have to represent the pressure of the first fluid as well as the second fluid. The pressure of the first fluid is given as p1 equals to p0 atmospheric pressure plus rho gh. So here density of the fluid into g. Height is h1 is equals r into 1 minus sin alpha, r into 1 minus sin alpha. Now we have to represent the pressure of the second fluid from the bottom, whereas it is represented as p2 is equals p0 plus rho gr. Here density of the first fluid is d1 and density of the second fluid is d2 gr into, after that h3 is sin alpha plus cos alpha, whereas remaining height h2 is given based on the first fluid and it is given as d1 into gr in 1 minus cos alpha. Since the fluid is at rest position, the two pressures will be same. So we can equate both the expressions. As we equate both the expressions, we can represent it as p0 plus d1gr into 1 minus sin alpha is equals to p0 plus, I am taking gr as common, gr into sin alpha plus cos alpha into d2 plus d1 into 1 minus cos alpha, 1 minus cos alpha. So here p0 gets cancelled and gr gets cancelled as you take a common. Then the remaining expression is d1 into 1 minus sin alpha is equals to d2 into sin alpha plus cos alpha plus d1 into 1 minus cos alpha. So bring this d1 into 1 minus cos alpha towards this side. As we bring that, we can take d1 as common. Then expression can be represented as 1 minus sin alpha minus of plus minus 1 minus of minus is plus cos alpha is equals d2 into sin alpha plus cos alpha. After that, minus 1 and plus 1 gets cancelled. So d1 into cos alpha minus sin alpha is equal to d2 into sin alpha plus cos alpha. Here we have to find the ratio of d1 by d2. So I'm going to bring this d2 towards this side and send this cos alpha minus sin alpha towards this side. Then expression can be represented as d1 by d2 is equal to sin alpha plus cos alpha by cos alpha minus sin alpha. Now I'm going to take cos alpha as common in numerator and denominator. Then expression can be represented as, if I take cos alpha as common, sin alpha by cos alpha is tan alpha. Tan alpha plus 1 by cos alpha is taken as common. So 1 minus sin alpha by cos alpha is tan alpha. Cos alpha and cos alpha gets cancelled. Then the ratio of d1 by d2 is equal to 1 plus tan alpha by 1 minus tan alpha. Take a screenshot. Please give a like to this video, share this video to our friends, and don't forget to subscribe my channel.